is Jayla.
I can see Jayla is dead. It's clear
enough. Through that fight, I feel like I'm losing everybody.
Sometimes I feel like I'm being attacked.
The whole thing is just emotional.
I need support. Transgenders are losing their life every single day. And I could have lost my life over there. But I chose to love myself.
This is what a superstar looks like.
She's an empowered woman.
She is a force to be reckoned with.
She comes from a whole family of legends.
She will always be my baby sister.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce Janet Jackson.
When I was 17, I did what people told me. I did what my father said and let my mother mold me.
This is my story, told by me, not through someone else's eyes. This is the truth. Take it or leave it. Love it or hate it. This is me.
Hey, my skin divas, dark, floozy, and light. It is your number one vixen, Foxy. Don't forget to head on over to our Instagram page, The Naked Truth. Make sure you go ahead and follow to keep updated with all the hottest things that's going on with your favorite celebrities and everything across the world. That's right, The Naked Truth is on Instagram. Head over there now. Views and opinions expressed in this broadcast is of the host and is just that, the views and opinions. If you get butthurt over any shit said during this broadcast, that means you are too damn sensitive for this. You have been warned. Viewer discretion is advised. What's going on, my skin diva Johnson, bluesy alike, and it's your number one vixen, Foxy. How you doing? You know what time it is. Fuck them hoes over there. It's nothing but wings and toes over here. Flip, flip, flip. That's right, it's our views, our voice, our naked truth. And y'all know we tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the naked truth. Get in here so we can start the show. Yeah!
Make sure the name got respect. All checks is a yes.
All checks is a yes. All checks is a yes. All checks is a yes. All checks is a yes. All checks is yes. Oh, I got like the new hair. That's just that respect. All checks is a motherfucking yes. Okay. Well, it's going on, boo. Thanks, my diva Dons and all floozies alike over there. It's your number one mission, international vixen, Foxy. Yes, make sure you guys share the broadcast. Come on in this motherfucker room. Oh, thank you. No, of course I can. No, and let's go. Give me out a little Oprah tonight, a little Michelle Obama tonight. Yes. Thank you, Allie. Yes. My hair, it moves. My hair, it moves. I don't know what you think is funny. Like Queen B, don't play about my honey, bitch, I ain't shit. Grinning the
What is going on, y'all? Are y'all ready for a good show? I am. Let me get my drink together. Because all checks is a yes. Yes, honey. Get the drink together. That's all I'm going to drink tonight, honey. Okay. What is going on, y'all? What's going on? Welcome, welcome, welcome to another amazing night of DNT Live, baby. Yes, Foxy B. Don't be confused with the El Nana, but I'm here to bring you the foolala on your favorite celebrities, current events, and all things that are things going on across the world. That's right, the number one, the international vixen, Foxy B. That's me. Okay, now let's get down and dirty. Okay, Pamela says, yes, I love me a good red wine. Yes, honey. You know, a woman of a certain age needs to start drinking red wine. You know, because red wine is good for your heart. You know, red wine is good for your body. That's what they say. Glass a day keeps the heart attack away. Oh, my God. I'm happy to be here with you guys. Okay, look, I'm sorry. I'm motherfucking sorry that we did not be here with you guys last week. Okay, so a lot has been going on, y'all. Floozy is not here with us tonight. He may join us later on, but all I gotta say for you guys is keep Floozy and his family in your prayers. Also, keep my family in your prayers. When I tell you guys, I'm losing my voice. Hold on. There we go. When I see that, ain't it? When I tell you guys that there is a lot going on between Floozy's family, I'm sorry, Marcus J. Darling, aka Floozy's family, and also with mine, y'all just won't believe what's going on. Okay, so just keep our families in your prayers. You know, I'm not going to go too much into Floozy's situation. If he wants to tell you guys, he could tell you guys. But, you know, with mine recently, I got both my mother and my baby sister, you know, the little one, Danielle, both in the hospital battling COVID. Okay? Both in the same hospital battling COVID. So I'm going through a lot. I wasn't going to go live tonight because I just wasn't in the spirit to do it. But I owed it to all of my boo things out there, my divas and dons, to go live tonight because y'all got to know what's going on. That's why I haven't been posting much. Y'all saw that. I was like, okay, I'm ready to move out of town, ready to move out of state. I was posting up on my social media. Where's a good place to live? I done narrowed it down to three places. We will get into that later. But it's just, with everything that's going on and with me and my, you know, with my new name and you know, and all the things that's going on, it's just time for a fresh start, you know. Foxy B needs a fresh start. And a lot of times that's considered a new zip code. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, Allie. Thank you so much, you know. But I rough it up because I have my hair down. Now let's talk about this hair though. Okay, so shout out to my hairstylist, Tia Bryant of Tia Moore Hair Salon in Lansing, Illinois. Y'all make sure y'all go check her out. She does the damn thing, okay? She does the damn thing. Now, Tia is the one that's been doing my braids and my little goddess locks and my butterfly locks, okay? So the last hairstyle I had goddess locks twice, and then I had the braids. And then I wanted to do butterfly locks. You know, it's me becoming into my womanhood, trying new hairstyles because all of this is new to me. Okay? All of this is new to me. You know, before I would just pop on a wig and call it a day, but I started incorporating my own natural hair because I knew my hair was growing and had got long and it's full, it's bouncy, and I'm hot right now with all these studio lights, honey. We got the shade fan today. But so she did my last hairstyle, which was the butterfly locks. Like I said, I'm trying different styles. I'm trying to find out what I like, what fits me. You know, this is still a journey that I'm going through. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to like get away from the wigs and I like, get used to like doing my own hair, and rocking my own hair. And so with the butterfly locks, it was cute, but it wasn't me. I didn't like it. It was way too much, and it was too much to try to style it and everything. So I had to get rid of the butterfly locks, y'all. And you know, with everything that's going on with my mother and my sister, I had to go get tested. And I was like, well, look, if I come back positive and I got a quarantine, I got to make sure my hair is where I could actually maintain it. Okay, I didn't want to be sitting in the house for 2 weeks with the butterfly locks and it's just looking horrible. You know what I'm saying? So this is what I, you know, came out the salon with. And I like it. I like it. Thank you, Michael Owens. Michael says, love the hair. She says, sexy. Okay, you better watch it, Michael. You better watch it. So I'm giving y'all a little bit of Oprah, a little bit of Michelle Obama. Okay, about to cut the ribbon at the groundbreaking, honey. And I got my broken shade fan today. And I don't know what's going on with it right now. There we go. Okay. So, yeah. So, here we are. All right. And like I said, keep my Marcus J. Donnie, a.k.a. Floozy, in y'all prayers. If he may join us tonight, he may not. But the show must go on. Okay. All right. So y'all know what's been going on with me. I've been dealing with the whole COVID with the family. Everybody in my family might have COVID. I got tested today. I'm waiting on the results. We will see. Okay. But I'm feeling fine. I don't have no symptoms. I do have a little cough. But every year around this time, you know, the season's changing. We're going into summer, into fall. So usually I would get a little sick because of the temperatures dropping and the body's getting used to the new temperature. And, you know, we still ain't wearing the appropriate clothes that we're supposed to wear with the temperature changing. We still rocking summer clothes. So, you know, and it's getting colder at night. I still, you know, keeping my window open and all of that. So every year around this time, I do get a little sick. But besides a little cough here and there, that's all I have. And I'm also fully vaccinated. So we will see when the results come back, if it's positive or negative. Hoping to say it's negative because a bitch got to keep making the money. I got to keep getting the coins. Okay. Yes, God. All right. So a little message to everybody. Please, if y'all go out to these restaurants, to these public places, go in there, mask up. Please go in there, mask up. We don't know who y'all been around. We don't know what party you're going to. Just mask the F up. Okay? Do that for me. Okay? Do that for me. All right? Yes. Okay, let's get into this show. It's been a lot going on, honey. So this show today is going to be a little bit different than what we usually do here on DNT, okay? I got people messaging me, okay? Look, breaking news coming through all kind of way. We usually have different segments of the show. We have What's the Celebrity, Now That's Fun Tea, and That Tea is the Truth. Not tonight. Tonight is all about the celebrities, okay? So we got no funny viral videos. We don't got no deep shit to talk about. We might talk about a little bit about the COVID later on. But tonight is mostly about the celebrities because, baby, it has been going down, okay? So we're going to get into it right now, y'all. We're about to get right into it. And what's the celebrity, honey? And fresh off the press, we're going to start it right here like this, y'all. Right here like this. Bam! Mr. 12 Play, Mr. I was gonna go there, but I'm not. Okay, are we definitely gonna get into Kelly Price? We're definitely gonna get into Kelly Price, but we're gonna start about our Kelly. That's why it's called the Kellys, honey, because we got two Kellys, baby. Two Kellys. That's on the top of everybody's list tonight, okay? R. Kelly has been convicted, you guys. Yes. R. Kelly has been found guilty of racketeering in federal sex trafficking case. I'm trying not to make no jokes about this. It's on the tip of my motherfucking tongue to make all kind of jokes because he's definitely going to be in the cell talking about filling on your booty, your booty, your booty, your booty, your booty, booty. I don't know if you're going to go half on the baby up in prison, y'all. I mean, woo! Somebody going to be filling on that booty, your booty. Tea, you boo 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 tea. Okay. So, according to the Shade Room, shout out to the Shade Room. R. Kelly has been found guilty by a federal jury Monday in sex trafficking trial following decades of numerous allegations of sexual assault and misconduct involving young women and children. Okay. Now, this conviction could carry on from 10 years to life. Now, mind you, he do still have other court dates in other states as well. So this is just, I think, in New York. So just in New York alone, he could be facing 10 years to life. This ain't including the other states that he still has to go to court for, okay? The Portia says, all them parents, managers, and staff need to be locked up too. Yeah, I agree with you because I sure believe that the parents knew what was going on. They was just getting paid, okay? They was getting paid hush hush money, okay? Now, doing the federal trial, I said child, didn't I? See, this is federal child. Huh? During the federal trial, jurors were shown. Now, get this, y'all. The jurors were shown homemade videos, okay, of R. Kelly engaging in sex acts that prosecutors said were not consensual. So y'all remember back in the day when there was a sex tape floating around with R. Kelly and he urinated. Allegedly, it was R. Kelly and he allegedly urinated on an underage girl. Well, there was more videos. Now, I remember a story not too far back where one of his boys from his camp said that that's what he did. He would have hidden cameras all over recording his acts with these people, with these young people. Now, so somebody gonna hit me up and was like, well, we would love to see those videos. I'm like, why would you want to see that? Why? Then I thought about it when the first sex tape came up. Everybody was crazy trying to go over the swap meet. Everybody was selling that sex tape, honey. Okay, forget Kim Kardashian's sex tape. The sex tape of sex tapes was the R. Kelly sex tape. That was the sex tape of all sex tapes. Everybody wanted their hand on that R. Kelly sex tape. Fuck Kim Kardashian. There go Marcus J. Dollar. Hey, Marcus, baby. Y'all say hey to Marcus. Say hi to Marcus, y'all. Okay? But that R. Kelly sex tape, everybody want their hands on that damn sex tape. But it was more of them, y'all. It was more of them. And they showed all these videos during the trial, honey. Okay? All these videos during the trial. Now, like I said, the conviction, he could be looking at a minimum of 10 years and a maximum of life. And that's only from New York. He still have court dates and I think he still have a court date here in Illinois, if I'm not mistaken. So he still has court dates in like 2-3 other states. So it could be possible that he could get up to like 3-4 life sentences. Maximum. Hey, Lola. So I don't know about y'all. Now, somebody had asked me, and I get this question a lot, that do I still bump R. Kelly music? And I was telling my hairstylist this morning when I was getting my hair done, shout out to Tia Bryant, that I can't listen to his music like I used to listen to his music. I think the only song that I may be able to listen to is Step in the Name of Love. And then it's like, I still can't, because I know some people can separate the artist from the man, or the gift from the man, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? They can separate the two. But we're talking about R. Kelly. We are talking about the music that he made. If you listen to the lyrics, I cannot listen. I swear to God, y'all. I cannot listen to Feeling on Your Booty. I can't listen to even a song performed by Aaliyah, Age Ain't Nothing But a Number. I can't listen to You Remind Me. I can't listen to 12 Play without my mind going to, like, was he talking about a little girl? Was he talking about a little boy? What was he doing? What was the inspiration behind this song? I want to know. That's how I feel. So I can't rock with R. Kelly music anymore. Every time it comes on, or like if I'm on YouTube or something, you know, you know how you go on YouTube and y'all do a little playlist and then an R. Kelly video might pop up. I got to skip it because I'm like, oh, nope, I can't do it. My baby sister, that's all. She loves watching music videos. And then every time an R. Kelly video, I run up in there and I change it real quick. Oh, hell no. You ain't not watching no R. Kelly video. I'm sorry. I am so sorry. Wait a minute. Let's see what Marcus J. Dollar said. Marcus J. Dollar says, free R. Kelly, and they ain't going to say he wasn't talking about me because I wasn't going to say shit. There go floozy, y'all. Now, see, if R. Kelly was singing about floozy, floozy would have never spoke. Floozy would have kept crying because we don't kiss and tell. We just try to make some jokes about it, guys. But on serious note, you know, a lot of people are saying this is good. That's happened to him. And then Nature Boy. Y'all know who Nature Boy is? He's like a social media influencer. I won't consider him an influencer. He ain't influencing me. But he's big on YouTube. He's big on social media, on Instagram, and I think Twitter. But I know most of YouTube. Nature Boy. You know, he's the one that's all about nature. And he got like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 wives or girlfriends. They all natural, 100% natural, bushy everywhere. No shade. But and he was talking about how the white man, now this is his words, not my words, but Nature Boy is going around talking about the white man made R. Kelly do it. The white man made us prosecute and convict R. Kelly. So a white man held R. Kelly's hand and made him do these things to these young people. Now, I would say, on a serious side, R. Kelly needed help. He needed help. But to me, I think R. Kelly had nobody but yes men around him. And all they saw was the dollar sign. That was it. That's all they saw. They saw the dollar sign. Not knowing that R. Kelly was going to be broke soon, because R. Kelly was too busy dibbing and dabbing and not making sure his contract was legit, to the tune of him not even owning anything. All these big mega hits and Grammys that he won, but he don't own none of his shit. Somebody could have said, R. Kelly, you need some help. Let's get you some help, because this ain't cool. What you're doing ain't cool. And I done caught up to his ass. Do I feel bad? I feel bad because R. Kelly is a legend. He is. I'm sorry. Y'all, we can't take that away from R. Kelly. He's a legend. The stuff he has, the music he has wrote and produced for us. Look at Michael Jackson. So not just only his music, but look at the music he has there for other people. Big artists, big names, icons. So he is a legend. I just wish it was somebody bold enough at the beginning to say, stop No, you need help. Let's get you some help before this gets out of control. Marcus said, yeah, he was bogus as hell. He had a true mental illness, and part of his condition was sex. He was addicted. And he could have got help for this. He really could have. He still can. Is there any comeback from this? I'm not sure. But our Cali man, moving on. Let's move along, buddy. Move along. Let's see, what's up, Michael Owens? You said, but aren't we all to some point? Are we all what? Sex addicts? That's what you're trying to say, Michael. Are we all to some point sex addicts? Yes. I don't know, because you now see, I gotta understand what a sex addict is, though. That's a true mental illness. That's an addiction. I don't think we are all sex addicts to some point. I won't put that on nobody, because a sex addict would go to the extreme to get pleased, or to please someone, whether it's rape, whether it's selling their bodies, whether it's paying for it, whether it's getting on drugs to please somebody in the hopes they would get sex. Being a sex addict, I won't put that on nobody. So I don't think we are all sex addicts to a certain degree. I would not put that on anybody. Okay? A sex addict and a freak are two different things. A sex addict and a freak is two completely different things. Okay? Oh, you could be a freak with the person you with, or if you're single and you're a freak, that don't mean you're a sex addict, because a freak still have standards. I'm a freak. But I'm not about to go pay for no sex. I'm not about to rape somebody because they won't give it to me because I need it. I'm not about to go out here and start, molesting because I need to please myself. That's a sex addict. Marcus J. Donovan says, I'm a middle-aged woman. Never mind Michael Owens' point taken. But I am a freak. Okay? So there's a huge difference between a freak and a sex addict. Those two should never be in the same sentence. Okay? That's why people say a sex addict is a freak of nature. But being a freak in the bedroom, okay, is nowhere on the level of being a sex addict. Okay? I have heard some horrible stories of people who are sex addicts. They will be out till the sun come up looking for sex. It's like being addicted to drugs. How you got people would do anything and everything to get that fix, to get that high. That's what a sex addict does. Like, that's a high to them. Having sex and that orgasm, that's a high to them. They would do anything and almost everything to get that pleasure. Okay. Okay. All right. Now, moving on. Moving on, honey. Let's get to Kelly Price. Baby. Kelly Price is not missing, y'all. Okay, so now I was woken up by my sleep. I was getting messages while at the JLB. I have been getting bombarded with all these videos and these clips of the news from all different states talking about Kelly Price is missing. Okay? So to anybody that has been living under a rock, I'm going to break down this story for you. Okay. Lotus says the Kelly Price story is really fishy to me. Yes. And we're about to break it down. We're going to break it down. Okay. All right. Miss Foxy about to break it down. Now, on July 29th, if I got the date correct, she went on her social media and said she had tested positive for COVID. And then nobody heard from her ever since. Right. The story goes that, you know, a wellness check was called. They went to her house. Supposedly, this is what the old original story was. Supposedly, kids or somebody answered the door and they said they haven't seen her. Like, she had got released from the hospital, but she never returned home. They don't know where she went. She's been missing for weeks. And that's how the whole thing of her becoming up missing, because nobody's seen her since she got released from the hospital. That was the original story. Okay, that was the original story. Now we're gonna find out, you know, that she was at home all this time. Okay, the story is Kelly Price came out. She finally did a video, and she was saying that, you know, when she was in the hospital, she got released, went home, quarantined with her boyfriend, her husband. Her husband was taking care of her. And then he ended up getting sick and catching COVID. And then she got really sick that she had to go to the hospital where she died for 2 seconds and then came back. But she said all the while, when she got released from the hospital, she was at home. When she tested positive for COVID, they released her because they needed the beds. They was running out of ICU beds, so they had to release her. They sent her home. She quarantined at home, and that's where she been. And she said, you know, the people that she talked to, she called the people, and the people that mattered to her, they knew where she was at. She was never missing. When the story it gets a little fishy is the sister and her daughter supposedly reached out to people to help look for her mother. Now, the question that everybody mind is, if Kelly Price says she was at home and supposedly a wellness check happened and they went to Kelly Price's home and the daughter or whoever said they haven't seen her, she has not been home, and it's been over a couple of weeks since she's been released from the hospital, the stories doesn't make sense. The daughter's telling one story, Kelly Price is telling another story. Okay. DoorDash was concerned. Everybody Instacart spilled the tea. Okay, so the thing that pissed a lot of people off is that when she did this video, she seemed a little irritated because she was talking about how she couldn't get no rest because people kept knocking on her door, kept ringing her doorbell, you know, going to the neighbor's house, going to people's houses in the neighborhood, asking them, have they seen her and stuff like that, only because it has been put out there that Kelly Price is missing. And my sister T.S. Madison even knew something was going on, because when she said that she had COVID and then just kind of disappeared, you know, even T.S. Madison said, y'all know Kelly Price tested for COVID. Somebody go around there and check on her. And this is before she was labeled missing. So people was worried about her. And the fact that she got irritated and upset that people was knocking on her door and ringing her doorbell, baby, those are people that cared about you. You was labeled missing. You was labeled missing. Why are you upset that people that actually cared about your ass to look for you? Now, if you was actually missing, ho, now we're going to get into it. Because at this point, it's fuck Kelly Price. That's what we're doing. Fuck Kelly Price. I said it. Fuck her. Because she had the whole world worried about her ass and her ungrateful ass wants to get on social media and got the nerve to have an attitude because people was concerned and was looking for her. Exactly. Exactly, Lola. How you gonna be mad because people care? Bitch, you haven't had a successful career in I don't know how many motherfucking years. But the fact that people still actually care about you, that there are still human beings on this planet that actually care about people, the fact that you went on social media and said you had COVID and then just all of a sudden disappeared, was worried. Which we don't know what happened. We don't know. And the story talking about you got released from the hospital and then you haven't been seen since. We don't know if you done got kidnapped, somebody put you in sex trafficking. We don't know what the fuck happened. We don't know if your new boyfriend, husband, whatever he is, that murdered you. Because the story got really fishy because even the lawyer started commenting for her. Talking about she's okay, she's in an undisclosed location. No, we wanted to see a toenail. We wanted to see a lip. We wanted to hear from Kelly Price, not from the attorney. So it started really seeming really fishy. Like, okay, why is everybody speaking for Kelly Price, but Kelly Price not speaking? It didn't make no goddamn sense. And here we go. Let's get into it. And we got some shit. We got to break this all the way down. Even the brat had to get into this, honey. Even the brat had to get into this. But we're going to break it down. So in this video, hey, Lyric. Hey, sis. So in this video, she claims that being quarantined at home, she had everything turned off. She had a cell phone turned off, the computer turned off, the TV turned off. After she didn't call whoever, then she needed to be called, you know, that was, you know, to tell her how she's doing or whatever. She had everything turned off. So she had no clue of what's going on the outside world. You trying to tell me that when news stations, radio stations, all over social media, what was reporting you missing? You trying to tell me not your agent, not your manager, not nobody for whatever record label that you part of or management company that you are part of say, hey, bitch, you know you missing? And no, you talking about you didn't speak to no, you trying to tell Foxy Kelly Price, a celebrity that you are, you got one phone. You don't got no assistant. It wasn't nobody to speak for you. You're not even your, you trying to tell me that nobody could tell you what the fuck was going on the outside world? Bitch, you're trying to tell me that as a celebrity with a platform that you have, knowing that all these other celebrities that got COVID or anything, they was like, you know, chronicling their journey through the COVID, going live, showing pictures, showing them, telling their fans how they doing, how they recuperating, all this shit. So you trying to tell me after you found out that you had COVID, you just gonna go blank and then let people think that you was missing? You didn't talk to nobody. See, this is don't seem right. It just don't seem right that the news stations and the radio stations, social media, gonna put out something that you was missing. But you said you had talked to people that they knew. The people that supposed to, that knew where you was at and knew how you was doing, they knew. So the thing that's confusing is how we get from people that knew where you was at to the point that you was missing. This went on for about a week or 2 weeks. And your story still doesn't make sense. You got your sister reaching out to people. Your sister is begging and pleading if anybody heard from Kelly, please let us know. Your sister up there are just begging it. But then you say, and then your sister said, y'all talk all the time. Y'all talk all the time, so this is unlike me to go this long without hearing from her. Then on your video, Kelly Price, you're talking about you haven't talked to your mother, I mean your sister, since your mother's funeral. It's been over a year. that y'all having a strange relationship, that y'all usually go a year, 2 years without even speaking to each other. So what is the truth? Your sister's saying I talk all the time, you saying you don't. And you're saying your daughter was manipulated. Now this is where it really gets fishy. Now you're trying to say your daughter was manipulated into going along with this whole you're missing story. Kelly Price, what the fuck is everybody going to gain out of saying you're missing? So now you're trying to tell us that all these people made up this story that you're missing. Everybody was lying. Again, as a celebrity that you are, as soon as the news broke that she was missing, especially on Atlanta news station, right then and there, you should have got on social media. No, look, I don't know what's going on, y'all. I'm not missing. I am fine. I am battling COVID. I'm quarantined. I'm fine. That's all you had to do. But instead, you get an attitude because people come into your house to check up on you, or people going to your neighbor's house to make sure they have seen you to see if you okay or are you really there? Because now everybody got these imaginations going through their head like, damn, did the husband kill her? Because even I thought that. I'm like, why is the attorney speaking for Kelly Price? No, we need to hear from Kelly. We need to hear her voice. Bitch, are you okay? Why is the attorney speaking for Kelly Price? And then she's going to go on her Instagram story and repost what her attorney said on her page. So we can see that, okay, well, Kelly Price did repost something, so maybe she's okay. And that made it even more fishy. Bitch, you haven't tweeted, posted, said shit all this time, but you're gonna repost something that your attorney said. That seemed fishy. She's getting just what she wants to pique everyone's interest and get free publicity. And that's exactly what Marcus J. Dolan said, because when the story broke, when I told him, you know, Kelly Price missing, Marcus J. Dolan laughed. He laughed. And he said this. He said, that bitch ain't missing. She just want attention. That's it. He said, that bitch ain't missing. She just wanted attention. That's all. Marcus said, she didn't have COVID. She had covers. Let's be honest. Okay. But Kelly Price, fuck you. Fuck you, Kelly Price, for having a whole world concerned about your safety. Okay? We got women coming up missing. You know how many black women come up missing and goes unreported? For you to have the damn nerve to do your little TMZ or whatever the fuck interview and have a little slight attitude because you was annoyed that people was coming to your house to do a wellness check to make sure you was okay, to see what the fuck was going on. You annoyed, ho? Fuck you, Kelly Price. This is the get for being concerned about your ass. This is the things we get for your washed up career ass. I said it because this is why you probably need attention to jumpstart your motherfucking career again. What, you got a reality show that's about to come out? Because anything that you're saying doesn't make sense to the shit that was going on. It doesn't. And I don't give a fuck who I offended. Fuck her. Fuck Kelly Price. You're canceled in my book. You are. had me work. Bitch, I was like, no! Like, what the fuck is going on? Oh my God, Kelly Price missing. Y'all, we gotta find her. We gotta find her. What's going on? What's going on with Kelly Price? Bitch, I was upset. I didn't even want to report it to y'all because I needed more information. Like, oh my God, what is going on? I'm watching all the news. I'm like, I'm trying to play detective, y'all. I'm seeing like, okay, we gotta find her. Back in my mind, I'm thinking about flying out to Atlanta, bitch. You know what I'm saying? We got to find back. We got to find Kelly Price. Just to find out, bitch. Ain't you haven't been missing. And then be mad. And I took it personal. You mad at me? I took it personal. You mad at me because I'm concerned? That we was out looking for your ass. You mad? You mad? Really? Now, if you was really missing, you would really want somebody to be looking for you. You would hope people are out there looking for you. Doing their due deals. Making sure they checking everything. But you got a nerve to be upset. I would have been like, oh my God, you know what? That means so much to me that a lot of people care about me to make sure that I was all right. I do. This was the proper way Kelly Price to handle this motherfucking situation. Apologize for scaring your fans. Apologize for scaring your motherfucking fans. And then say you appreciate that the world cared about you. Enough to look for you and check on your well-being, to even go to your neighbor's house and ask questions. Be grateful for that, that people cared enough for you to do things like that. She just needed time to regroup. Well, regroup to Foxy's council list. Child. She said, now that's not going to happen. Okay? It's not. Let's give it back to the right side. I always mess it up. It's not. This wine got me hot, y'all. Hold on. I got to stop drinking this wine. This wine got me hot. This wine kicking in. Y'all can tell when this wine is kicking in, y'all. This wine kicking in, y'all. All right. Now, look. This whole Kelly Price story has evolved into a big mess. Okay, it's just evolved into a big mess. And let me tell you something right now. The Brat versus Nikki Gilbert. The Brat has jumped into this ring. The Brat has been brought into this. Okay, I'm a build up this story for you guys. So Nikki Gilbert decided to go on social media to talk about the whole situation with Kelly Price and about her daughter and, you know, how her daughter reached out to her and, you know, she worried about this, but at the same time, promoting Brownstone. Promoting Michael Jackson record label, promoting everything that deals with Brownstone. Basically using Kelly Price situation as clout because the whole world was talking about Kelly Price. And so the Brat felt some type of way and was basically saying that, you know, Kelly Price was wrong for using her platform and bringing Kelly Price into it and all her whatever that's Kelly Price going through, then on the back end, going to talk about her shit. Like you're using Kelly Price situation as clout. You know what I'm saying? So when Kelly Price saw that the Brat had an issue with it, Kelly Price did another interview basically explaining herself and basically explaining herself to the Brat. Okay? So this is another one. So let's check this out. Here's the interview that Nikki Gilbert did regarding Kelly Price and the whole situation, y'all. We'll be back.
So, yeah. About, I don't know, beginning of, well, we all saw that Kelly announced that she had COVID on social media, right? And we were all concerned. You know, I talked to Kelly a few times prior to that. I think I invited her to my birthday party. And we had talked about a few other things. Her grandmother passed away. So I was, of course, reaching out, as everybody in this industry will tell you, we all kind of, few of us, you know, kind of really genuinely care about each other and really check in with each other. So I was checking in with her. Kelly never responded. I sent her a text after, you know, I gave her some time after she made the announcement, sent her a text. I think I sent her a DM. She never responded. So we then started getting requests. And by we, I mean Brownstone. We started getting requests to fill in for Kelly's dates. So we got a request to fill in for her date in Philly. We said, you know what? This is a date in Philly. This is great. We hate that Kelly's not here, but let's go rock it out and let's do a Kelly Price tribute and let's say, hey, Kelly, get better.
Sure,
and we added a Kelly Price tribute in the show. The band did a little nothing. Ain't nobody missing no money. Something must be serious with Kelly. Nobody's missing out on some money. Something's got to be serious. So I reached out to Nia, her daughter, who I've met, who I know is her daughter. I said, Nia, I reached out to her and said, just checking in, sweetheart. You know, we're playing some dates that your mom is playing. Please tell me everything is okay. Is she okay? Right? Nia's response to me was immediate and very serious. I'm not going to go into the specific details of that, but she said, Miss Nikki, can you please call me? It's important. When she said it, I said to my husband, oh my God, this sounds like something could be wrong. I'm scared to even call her back. I don't want to get drugged in the middle of it. I'm scared Nia, you know, well, what can you do? Can you call, you know, this person? Can you call that person? I know she was working with this person. She said to me, there is no one that I am comfortable having this conversation with but you. Now, I don't know what the dynamics are going on in the family. I don't know. It doesn't matter. My friend is on life support. I'm shocked that I'm the person that she's like, I need to talk to you. She's like, but I see your advocacy. I know my mom respects you. I know you have my mother's back. Will you please talk to me about what I need to do for my
Nikki. Fuck you, Nikki Gilbert. Fuck you too. Fuck you, Nikki Gilbert. Okay? Now look. You use Kelly Price for clout. That's it. Just say it. You did. And the fact that you even dragged in a lot of personal information that's not yours on this interview. No, we didn't all need to know if there's a problem going on between Kelly Price and her daughter. That's not for us to know. And it's none of your goddamn business either. For you to assume that there must be some type of bad tension between Kelly Price and her daughter, and for you to say it out loud on an interview with thousands and thousands and thousands of people watching was very inconsiderate, very rude, and very bitch-like. You're using Kelly Price's clout to promote Brownstone, to promote your performance, and that you got other performances coming up and all this stuff. But it's so I'm let me get out because I'm about to get upset. I'm getting upset with Nikki now. Well, I'm already upset with the hoe. So the brat felt some type of way. The brat felt some type of way because that interview was a rebuttal to what the brat had said about Nikki Gilbert using her platform as clout. Basically saying, bitch, if Kelly Price didn't call you, but she called other people, bitch, you're not that important for Kelly Price to call you. And what you're doing is wrong. So that interview that Nikki Gilbert was her response to the brat. So the brat and the brat's fiance, Judy, my baby Judy, was in that live. And Judy was like trying to tell the interviewer to bring me up because they was going to address Nikki Gilbert in that live at that moment, but they never did. So the brat, after that live ended, the brat went live to address Nikki Gilbert. And when I tell you, the Chi-Town side of the brat came out and I got the video. So here is the brat responding to Nikki Gilbert's interview. And we'll be back right after this.
Was gonna go left. I told you, baby, we shouldn't have listened to it. You up now. Get on live. Reach out. That's what you want to do? Let's do it. And you damn right feel about the Kelly situation. Up. Like I said before, I didn't want to get involved in it. I got off a plane tired from doing Hurricane Ida relief, giving back. You know what I'm saying? And I felt because my friend Kelly, who I've been talking to for years, been knowing for years, since before R&B Divas, she used to sing background for Mariah Carey, my best friend, when Tommy Mottola was the president of Sony. We all used to be around each other as kids. So don't do that and say what I don't know. Now, I don't know the conversation. You're right. I don't know that. But I do know you fell for the okie doke because she ain't talked to her sister in over a year since her mom passed away. But did you know that? But no, y'all so close. Why are you telling the story about what her daughter did and what her daughter said? Like, that is messy. 5 miles till messy. This what you want? Let's do it. I don't even do this. Friend, she ran her mouth too much. Don't come in here disrespecting my baby now. That's a whole different problem. Okay, that's a whole can of worms you don't want to open up. And I commend you for your platform and what you use it for. But don't lie on people and don't tell people's business. I'm not gonna talk about this, but you've been on that mother 3 minutes talking. You don't wanna do this? Yeah, we go way back too. But me and Kelly go way back even before that. And why are they bringing up Michael Jackson and the group and the R&B divas and all that? Like, what are you talking about? If you're doing your platform thing, do what you advocating for. You saved it all the way until the end so people could listen to what you had to say. And that's all I was saying in my post. I was upset because you talking about Kelly to promote your you telling Kelly's personal business. Kelly called a whole bunch of her friends that fucked her, that checked on her, that made sure she was okay and didn't stop checking on her. She know who checked on her. She do.
Girl,
I don't want to do this.
I know.
No, you didn't try to say something about hair products. You need to get you some Miracle Drops. The friend is talking. I don't like that. I don't like that. Now, don't do that. This ain't what you want. Don't do that.
This ain't what you want. Tell her, brat. I like the brat. Brat, I love the brat and Judy. Now, let me go. I'm going to backpedal a little bit. Now, I said fuck Kelly Price because I'm pissed at her. I may love her later on, but fuck her right now, okay? Because I'm knowing a lot of people are going to be like, why you say that about her? If she really did have COVID, then my sympathy go out to her. But what I'm pissed off at Kelly about, when I'm saying fuck Kelly right now, is because she had the whole world looking for her and she had the nerve to have a slight attitude for the people that was concerned about her, the people that actually love her, the people that still care about her, her fans. That's why I said fuck Kelly Price. How are you gonna be mad at us for caring about you? So that's why. Okay, not because she had COVID and all that stuff. That COVID is serious. I told you I got my mother and my sister in the hospital now battling COVID. But I said fuck Kelly because of the attitude that she has towards the people that were worried about her, her fans. Okay. Now Nikki Gilbert is a whole different story. Okay. All right, fuck her all across the board. Because what she did was dirty. That was real dirty. Okay? And like the brat said, this ain't what you want. Now, y'all remember when Nikki Gilbert also had some personal things to say about Whitney Houston, and they dragged her ass for that. Nikki, you just need to use your platform for you and not trying to sit here and speak about any other celebrity, because it seems like you keep getting dragged every single damn time you do. Like the bread said, you told her that you wasn't going to talk about it, but you still talked about it and drawed people in just to promote your shit. Brad knows this business like the back of her hand. She knew exactly what... Yeah! She used Kelly Price as clout. The Brad was basically saying her real friends knew what was going on. And again, like I said, if Kelly Price had COVID, sympathy goes out to her. I believe she did have COVID. I ain't gonna say she didn't. It's just the fact that, like I said, she got pissed off at people that was worried about her. That's what I'm pissed off at it about. But, like the Brat said, people that mattered to her knew what the fuck was going on with her. That people that mattered to her, she had spoke with. So Brat was back to saying, bitch, if you didn't hear from Kelly Price, if you called and your call went unanswered, bitch, you don't matter to Kelly Price. You're not that friend. That's what the Brat was saying. And then for you to go further, to bring in her daughter, to bring in her sister, and then use your platform to narrate this whole fucking story for clout was wrong. Now, should we call Selena Johnson on you? I think me and Marcus could get a hold of Selena Johnson. Do we need to call Selena Johnson on you? Do we need to call Lisa Ray on you? Nikki Gilbert, stop. Use your platform for what you advocate for. I like Nikki Gilbert's platform. But what she did was down and dirty, and I can't rock with that. And for that, I don't give two fucks about Nikki Gilbert. She's canceled. She's been washed up for I don't know how many years as it is. You know what I'm saying? She's always trying to find something to stick her name to for clout lately. And if y'all paid attention, she's always trying to attach herself to something big. Whether it's to talk bad about it or whether it is to find some reason not to support it, whatever it is, in order just to gain more people to her. Marcus A. Donna said exactly, because I wanted hot out of Popeye's her ass. Hell, I like chicken. I want to. Nikki. Sit down, boo. Sit down. Get back to your African stuff. And girl, when you gonna learn? When you gonna learn? They dragged you for Whitney. Now they're dragging you for Kelly Price. Just stop. Stop. Army Divas is not gonna happen again. Child, just stop. Jesus. The Havoc is saying she talented. Nikki, I didn't need to do that. What? Oh, she's talented. She didn't need to do that track. She's very talented. Nikki could sing down boots, but she has a washed up career at that. I'm sorry. She do, but she could sing down boots. I ain't not going to take away her talent, but what she did was come on now. I don't want to hear her music now. I don't care. I don't care about her music. I want Kelly Price to put out some music. I don't care about Nikki Gilbert, but Kelly Price put out some more music. I'm here for Kelly Price. I ain't here for what she did, though. How she treated her fans. I ain't there for that, but I love her music. I'd rather Kelly Price put out new music before Nikki Gilbert put out new music. I'm just saying. But let's go to the person that's not putting out any more new content on TV. no time soon. Cynthia Bailey, y'all. Cynthia Bailey Hill is leaving Housewives of Atlanta. Is she leaving or did she get fired? That's the question. Okay, that is the question that we all want to know. Did Cynthia get fired or did she leave on her own accord? Okay. Wait a minute, Marcus, what you just say? She could put a new shit and survive. This was Jada Tater Salad. Tater Salad. Okay, so as you guys know, I had the clip, but I didn't have the energy to fight against Wendy Williams' production company. But as you guys remember, Cynthia Bailey earlier this summer was on the Wendy Williams show. And Wendy was like, she see that Bravo, Andy Cohen is shaking it up with the Real Housewives of Atlanta cast, and it seems like someone may be losing their peach or some of you will be getting fired. And Cynthia agreed. And Wendy was like, well, I feel the person that should be getting fired is you. Now, Wendy cleared it up and she said, I want you to get fired because you have so many good things going and I don't want to watch it deteriorate on the show like so many other marriages. Like she just had married. She got a beautiful, you know, husband and everything is looking good for Cynthia and she just didn't want to see it go down in waste on the show because she knows how, and we know, we see it all the time, these reality shows could do some damage to somebody's marriage. We see it all the time. Love in Huntsville, other Real Housewives franchises, all these reality shows does some damage to married couples. And so she felt that you have nothing else to bring to the table. You at your peak. So this is the time for you to lead the show. Well, Bravo confirmed that they will be changing up some faces on the Housewives of Atlanta, and we'll be sending some people away, getting rid of some faces. So, all of a sudden, yesterday, Cynthia released a statement on her Instagram. Okay? And this is what Cynthia has to say, y'all. Cynthia said, after much thought and consideration, I have made the very difficult and heartfelt decision not to return for the next season of Real Housewives of Atlanta. Thank you, NBC Universal, Bravo, and Truly Original for over a decade of partnership. I can't wait to see what we do next. Thank you to my Real Housewives of Atlanta castmates for 11 of the most unbelievable years of my life and the most incredible and unforgettable memories. I am so grateful to have this amazing journey, and I am anxiously waiting to embark on new adventures. Most importantly, thank you to my fans. I could not have done it without your blessings, love, and support. Without the fans, none of this would be possible. I love and appreciate all of you. She goes on to say, it's time to move on to my next chapter, and I look forward to sharing it with all with you. See you guys soon. Cynthia Bailey Hill. She got Bigo kicked. So the question is, did Cynthia Bailey Hill get fired or did she walk away? Now, word on the street is she got the band. And she is supposed to make a statement a while ago. Bravo sent her an email saying that you need to announce your departure from the show or we will. And that's why Cynthia had to make that post yesterday. So it seems like, and I honestly believe that she got fired because Bravo did say they would be making some changes to the cast of The Real Housewives of Atlanta because of their lackluster season they had last season. Very lackluster. Very, very The only hype of the season was Bolo. And the whole, and we talked about this, all these grown women trying to find out who slept with Bolo. Who cares? If y'all think it was Portia, she was single at the time. If you think it was somebody, who cares? The fact that that was the hype of last season, who slept with Bolo? That means y'all don't got nothing else to offer. So now with Cynthia out of the picture, now I think Portia may be out of the picture. I think Portia is walking away from the Housewives. It has not been confirmed. But earlier in the middle of summer, Portia had released some statements on her Instagram and in her social media pages saying things that, you know, it's time for a change, you know, with new things because new adventures, blah, 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 blah. Leading people to believe that she is stepping away from the Housewives franchise as well. So, well, Nene out the picture, and Nene confirmed today that she is not returning to Housewives of Atlanta this season because there's rumors were speculating that the reason why Cynthia got fired is because they wanted Nene back. But Nene confirmed that it's not the case, and she is not returning back to the Housewives of Atlanta this season. Now, she said this season. So, is Nene coming back a couple of seasons later? Is there conversations of her coming back to the show? Because the way she said, no, I'm not coming back this season. Because why does this say, sorry guys, no, I would not be returning to the Housewives of Atlanta. And leave it like that. Why would you say, sorry guys, I'm not returning to the Housewives of Atlanta this season? So that means you left the door open that you may be coming back, just not this season. But she was just clearing up that, you know, she's not coming back. So without Nene, without Cynthia, really, I didn't give a damn about Cynthia. Cynthia was kind of boring on the show. I think her marrying Mike Hill and having Mike Hill on there actually gave a little bit more life to Cynthia's storyline on the show. Like, because Mike Hill is fine as hell. So I always love watching Housewives of Atlanta just to see Mike Hill. So Mike Hill kind of added some pizzazz to Cynthia's life on the show. But without Nene, without Cynthia, and possibly without Portia, that only leaves Candy in Kenya and what's her name? Dador. What's her name? What's the girl name? What's the girl's name? Drusador. Lord Jesus. I don't know why I couldn't get her name out. So we got Drusador, Candy, and Kenya. That's only three peaches. Y'all got four peaches to fill. So to me, next season's gonna be all new bitches. Because you only got Drusador, who's confirmed that she would get a peach next season. She's is safe. Kenya, of course, is gonna be back. And Candy. And now, I remember a couple of months ago, rumors going around that Candy wasn't coming back as well. Now, here's the thing. Candy said, or the rumor was that Candy was returning because they was bringing Phaedra Parks back. Not only was they bringing Phaedra Parks back, they was also bringing back, y'all ready? Sheree. So Sheree and Phaedra, that was the rumors. Now, this is how I caught this tea. If y'all Google, somebody leaked pictures. Mm-hmm. If you Google Housewives of Atlanta, and if the pictures come up with they're all in black, that are new pictures from the past season. But if you pay a close attention to who's in that picture, Phaedra Parks is there. I was like, excuse me, y'all. When I saw that, I was like, wait a minute. Phaedra Parks wasn't on the season with Drusador. Phasia Parks been gone for a little minute now. Because I'm like, okay, I see Candy. I see Cynthia. I see Portia. I see Candy, Kenya, Portia, Cynthia, Drew, and then I see Phaedra. I was like, Phaedra wasn't in this past season. I was like, ooh. Bitch, who done leaked this picture? So rumor has it that Phaedra is returning back to Housewives. And everybody know that Sheree wants to return back, but she wants to hold a peach. She don't want to be a friend to the show. And that she only wants to return for one season. But that's only two people. You still got 2-3 more spots to fill. So y'all be able to prepare. Housewives of Atlanta next season is going to be basically all new people. And some people are saying it's worth it because the storylines are getting the same. It's getting boring. Kenya Moore is always fighting with the same. We're tired of Kenya and Portia fighting. We're tired of it. They've been doing that since Portia got on the show. Kenya has been out the Portia's head. I don't know why. Y'all better leave Nene's little sister alone. Now, I want Portia to return because I feel like Portia kind of took the reins of Nene. You know what I'm saying? This past season, you could see, like, Portia was Nene's protege. You know, you could tell that's Nene's, you know, play little sister, and that Portia looked up to Nene, all that stuff. You could see it in this past season. And I was like, I want Portia to return because I want to see what more is Portia going to bring to the show. Now that the whole storyline of her and the guy that she's engaged to that was once her friend's husband. So that's a good, juicy storyline right there. How that happened? Evidently, the door wasn't closed. Portia, the door was wide open. How that happen? How'd you end up being engaged to your friend's ex-husband? Okay. And she seems so happy now. So I would love for her to return to the show because I would love to see that play out. I would love, if it's true that Phaedra Parks is returning, the dynamic between Candy, Phaedra, and Portia. We all been waiting for that. We all have been waiting for that because y'all got rid of, after that season, when Phaedra had forced Portia to say that Candy said something in her drink and raped her or something like that in the dungeon, sex dungeon, they kicked Phaedra off the show. So we never got to see the three play out. We got to see Candy and Portia play it out the next few seasons. But now, if we get Phaedra to come back, if Phaedra's actually coming back, we now get to see, because, you know, Portia and Candy done made up, they done moved along, put it behind them. They, you know, they buddies now. But now that Phaedra's back in the picture, how is that going to play out? How is that going to play out? Do Candy still have animosity to Phaedra? Is Phaedra going to come back and apologize and try to fix what she broken, which she broke with Candy and with Portia? I would love to see that play out. And that's going to have to play out at least over 3 more seasons. So that right there, if they can get Phaedra back and keep Candy on, because I remember a while ago, Candy said she's out if they bring Phaedra back. But then I heard recently, maybe about a month ago, that she's okay if they bring Phaedra back. Because Candy, you know, girl, you an entrepreneur. You a businesswoman first. You're about those coins. If Phaedra comes back, you know how many viewers would come back to the Housewives of Atlanta franchise? Because we basically going to pick up where y'all left off, you, Candy, and Phaedra. That reunion. When you went off on Phaedra about the lies she's spreading about you trying to rape Portia. We're going to pick off right there. So you know the viewer's going to tune in for that. Like, oh, we got to see this play out. what's about to happen, girl? What Candy gonna say to Phaedra? What Phaedra gonna say to Candy? What Phaedra gonna say to Portia? What Portia gonna say to Phaedra? When they all three gonna get together, what they gonna say together? You know that's gonna happen. Wait a minute, y'all. Hold on. This camera. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Oh, shit, y'all. Hold on. There we go. Y'all know that's gonna happen. So, that Bravo Andy Cohen. Bring Phaedra back. Because we, y'all pay Portia. Y'all keep Portia. Keep Portia at least for another two more seasons. This season, y'all know y'all, she got her spinoff that's happening, y'all, with her new man. So she got her own series coming out. It's a spinoff on The Housewives. So you got that. And then she do at least one more season. And then y'all let her go. But y'all pay Portia her money. Okay? Because y'all bring Phaedra back. Y'all got to pay Portia. Y'all make sure y'all pay Candy. Because that season, when you got Phaedra, Portia, and Candy back, that's going to be a blowout season. Because that's what we are, because we never got closure for that. The fans never got closure. I'm sure Portia, Phaedra, and Candy never got closure from it. Or if they did, they did it behind the scenes. But you know, the fans, we want to see it on camera. That's going to be tea. And then me and Marcus was talking about people y'all could bring to the show to liven it up some. So y'all ready? Here's my suggestion. I said, well, Marcus said Selena Johnson. No, I said Selena Johnson. No, Marcus did. Marcus, you said Selena. We said bring Selena Johnson to the Housewives of Atlanta. Pay her. Selena lives in Atlanta. She's a wife. She already got a brand. She's always got, Selena got a humongous ass following. Bring Selena Johnson to Housewives of Atlanta. Pay her. Pay her. Because I know that's the only thing that's probably keeping Selena from being on there. The money. Pay her. Because outside of Candy, Selena would be a big name on the show. And I would love to see the dynamics between Selena and Candy because they both are singers. And Kelly is a producer. Candy is a producer. So I'm sure Selena and Candy probably going to do a song or album together. Bring Selena Johnson to the Housewives of Atlanta. Because what you're going to need, I'm sorry, Andy Cohen, Bravo, y'all don't need fresh new faces. That's not going to work. You're going to need some names. Y'all done built this empire. You need names. Like Gabriel saved the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. Y'all going to need a big name to save the Housewives of Atlanta. Bring in Selena Johnson. Hell, bring in motherfucking Nikki Gilbert. I don't like that hoe, but bring in Nikki Gilbert. Selena and Nikki got this little, it's like a little strange little beat going on between them. So the tension between them, bring them on. But you know Nikki Gilbert ain't going to do it because she thinks that's... But Selena Johnson would be a perfect addition to the Housewives of Atlanta. Marcus, I see you at the bottom, but your camera not on. Do you want to be on camera? We got Floozy in the building. He's at the bottom. Do you want to be on camera? Oh, okay. You said no. You want me to bring you up? Okay, he said, never mind, nothing. Okay. But I feel Selena Johnson would be a great fit to the show. Hell, I hate to say it, but I think who would be entertaining for the Housewives, I'm sure they probably asked her, but with the right money, and hell, give her some type of credit. Tamar Braxton would be a good fit for the Housewives of Atlanta. I'm just saying. Tamar Braxton would be a good fit for the Housewives of Atlanta. We don't got the Braxtons no more, but she could put her on the Housewives of Atlanta. You need a big name to save the franchise of the Housewives of Atlanta outside of Candy. Candy's a big name on the show, but we know Candy. We grew with Candy. Candy has been on there for a long time. Oh, we also said the Brat or Judy. Her fiance, soon to be wife. Put Judy on the Housewives of Atlanta. Now, I say it where they already on Grown Up Hip Hop Atlanta. But I think I would like them better on the Housewives. That would be groundbreaking to have a lesbian married couple, big names like the Brat and Judy on the Housewives of Atlanta. But it will be Judy as the star. You know what I'm saying? The focus will be on Judy. Not so much on the Brat, but the focus would be more on Judy. I don't think T.S. Madison would do it, baby. T.S. Madison too busy right now. I don't think T.S. Madison would do the Housewives, but only because she got her own show going on. T.S. Madison, my sister, got her own show going on, so I don't think she would do Housewives of Atlanta, honey. I don't think she would do it. I really don't think she would do it. But I think Judy would be a great fit for the Housewives of Atlanta, you know, with the Brat on there. And I said Rashida and Kirk. Rashida and Kirk has outgrown Love and Hip Hop. I'm sorry, Mona Scott Young. I'm here. I'm saying it right now. Rashida and Kirk has outgrown Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. They are entrepreneurs that have built a motherfucking empire. Okay? They have outgrown Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. I think it's time for them to move on to a bigger show outside. I mean, I'm gonna say that Real Housewives is bigger, but it kind of is. but Real Housewives, I think Kirk and Rashida should move. Well, not move. They already live in Atlanta, but should go to Housewives of Atlanta. I think Rashida will pay, and then Rashida and Ken. Good friends. They already sisters. Rashida and Candy go way back. Okay? Way. They got songs together. So, I mean, Candy and her husband, they already know and already kick it with Rashida and Kirk. So, I think that is a no-brainer to bring Rashida and Kirk over to the Housewives of Atlanta franchise. That right there would be amazing. That would get people back in tune with the Housewives of Atlanta. Okay, Marcus J. Dunn said Tiana Taylor. I would say yes for Tiana Taylor and Amon, but she got her own show. I can't say people that got their own show because they're getting their own bag. I would say Tiana Taylor, if she didn't have her own reality show, if she didn't have that, then I would say yeah. I would love to see Tiana Taylor on a Housewives of Atlanta show. But she got her own show where it's focused on her and her family and nobody else. So, and I love it. I love Tiana Taylor and Amon's reality series. I love it. On WE TV. Is it WE TV or is it Bravo? It's one of them two. But I love it. But I think Rashida, baby, if you're listening to me, Candy, if you're listening to me, you need to reach out to Rashida. Y'all need to do something. Rashida, when is your contract up for Love and Hip Hop? When is your contract up for Love and Hip Hop? And you need to join your sister Candy over there on the Housewives of Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? And then the dynamics. And ooh, there you go. See, I already called it up. You got Candy, Rashida, okay? When Phaedra comes back into play, okay? So you got that dynamic between Portia, Phaedra, and Candy. And Candy got her sister, Rashida, going to toe for her girl, for her sister. Then you got Sheree, the bone collector. Then you got Kenya, who I know ain't going to like Rashida. And Rashida ain't going to like Kenya. I already know. And you already know Phaedra and Kenya don't like each other. So there's going to be a strange kind of a thing, because I think Rashida's going to like Phaedra, even though she don't care. She's gonna end up growing to like Phaedra because of their both their dislikes for Kenya. Rashida ain't going to like Phaedra at first because of what Phaedra had done to Candy. But because Kenya be coming after Rashida, because Kenya always come after the new girl, even though Rashida ain't a new girl. Okay? But Kenya always coming after whoever's new on the show. And Rashida, I know how Rashida is. Rashida ain't going to play that shit. And you already know Phaedra and Kinga don't like each other. So Rashida and Phaedra is going to end up forming some type of friendship because they both dislike Kenya. Which is going to force Rashida to be in the middle of Phaedra and Candy. So Rashida, because y'all know Rashida don't love hip hop, is already the peacemaker. And all about love and you know, rekindling things, all that stuff. So you know that's how Rashida is now. So you already know Rashida is going to try to bridge whatever that situation is between Candy and Phaedra. I already see it. I see it. Because Rashida and Phaedra is end up going to be friends. And she's going to try to fix whatever that needs to be fixed between Phaedra and Candy. And Portia ain't going to like that. Because Portia now is going to have a problem with Rashida. And that's going to force Phaedra and Kinga to finally be on the sides together. Because both of them ain't going to like Rashida because of the shit that she's trying to do with Phaedra and Candy. Because Portia's gonna be like, how dare you? Candy is my friend. That's my sister. Fuck Phaedra and what she did to us. I'm not ready to mend those fences yet. The doors to her is closed. But how dare you try to fix shit between Phaedra and Candy? So that's gonna make Phaedra feel some kind of way about Rashida. There you go, Bravo. And then Tisha host the motherfucking reunion. Okay. Okay. Put Megan and Harry on this. No. We ain't putting no Megan and Harry out there. But there you go, Andy Conway and Bravo. We need to find out. Y'all need to contact Mona Scott Young. We need to find out when is Rashida's contract up. Okay. For Love and Hip Hop. Or is it somewhere where she could do both? If she could do Love and Hip Hop and do the Housewives show, okay? And we need to get Rashida and Kirk over to the Housewives of Atlanta. We need to go ahead and bring Phaedra on back. So then you want to have Candy, Rashida, Phaedra, Kenya, Portia, and Drusadora. There's your peaches. There's your six wives. You're welcome, Andy Cohen. You're welcome. Oh, and Selena Johnson. If you could get Selena, that would be great. She'd be the seventh peach. Okay, she'd be the seventh peach. But if not, then, you know, you say, hey, you got Rashida over there. Okay, and you got Phaedra back. Oh, and Sheree. So you start, okay, so we're going to leave Selena Johnson out of there because you got Sheree. So Sheree is the seventh peach. Okay, I forgot Sheree is coming back. So you got Sheree. So we got Sheree, we got Phaedra, we got Portia, we got Kenya, we got Drusadora, we got Candy, and we got Rashida. That is your new season of Housewives of Atlanta. Boom. Now y'all know I'm good coming up with this stuff. I've done it for movies, and motherfuckers have listened to me. Tyler Perry listened to me, okay? Tyler Perry has listened to. I'm good at coming up with these scenarios and storylines and how it should go. That's going to grab the fans' attention. I'm good at that. This is what I do. I come up with shows and ideas. This is what I do. She said, leave Sheree where she at. But Sheree already says she wants to come back. Sheree is the good bone cutter. See, Sheree likes to start a pot. That's why Sheree is good for the show. okay? A lot of people didn't like Sheree, but Sheree stirred the pot. She was the bone collector. She's going to definitely come to you and tell you what so-and-so said about you. She likes to stir the pot. That's why we need Sheree, okay? See, Sheree and Rashida is going to be so cool. And, you know, and she's going to be around Candy, and she's going to be hearing things. They're going to say things about Phaedra, you know, and Sheree's cool with everybody. So Sheree's going to kick it with Phaedra, and it's probably going to kick it with Phaedra and Juicedora, because Juicedora is going to like Phaedra. Okay, and they're going to kick it with each other, and then Sheree's going to end up telling Phaedra what Candy has been saying about her and all this stuff, you know, and then Juicedora is going to say shit about Kenya. So whenever Sheree is around Kenya, she's going to tell Kenya everything Juicedora has been saying about her, because you know Juicedora and Kenya, they got issues. They got beef. So we need Sheree, because Sheree is the bone collector. That's how everything is going to get started and stirred up. It's because of Sheree, because Sheree is cool with all of the wives on there. So she kicks it with everybody. So she's going to hear some tea about one of the other ladies. So she's going to end up eventually telling the other ladies what the other lady has said about them. And then every time they get into a group setting, they're going to wake it up. So you need a Sheree on your show. You need a bone collector on your show. That's good. A bone collector is basically, for those that's asking, is somebody who's actually and literally cool with everybody. They don't got no problems, no beefs, no arguments, no nothing. They get along with every single person on the show. So that means they're always invited somewhere with someone on the show. They get all of the tea. And every time, so like for instance, If Sheree goes out with Juicedora and Phaedra, they go out to dinner or they go shopping or something, Juicedora is probably gonna talk some mad shit about Kenya. Okay, now Sheree is cool with Kenya, so now the next time her and Sheree and Kenya go out, okay, or Sheree goes to the Kenya house, Sheree's gonna end up, girl. So, you know, I went out with Phaedra and Juicedora the other day, girl, and Juicedora had a lot to say about you. Okay? And then with King, whatever King is say, so the next time she see Juicedora, she gonna tell her what King is saying. So when every time they're in a big setting, either, you know, King ain't gonna bring it up, but Juicedora is definitely gonna bring it up. And it's the same thing with Rashida and Candy, you know what I'm saying? Because Sheree is cool with them. So she goes out, she'll probably, you know, Candy probably invites Sheree to the studio. Rashida's in there, Rashida comes and they're talking. And then Sheree, being a bone collector, she's like, child, you know, I just came from Phaedra's house. And I'm having a thing and I'm inviting everybody. And then Candy's like, well, are you inviting Phaedra? I'm gonna invite everybody. Why? You and Phaedra haven't fixed y'all problem or talked about it. Then Candy is gonna say something nasty about Phaedra and all this shit. And then Rashida like, oh yeah, that's yeah. And then you know, Rashida probably put her little two cents in. And then Sheree, next time she out with Phaedra, she gonna twist Rashida words or something a little bit, to make it seem like Rashida was being real shady to Phaedra, but she's definitely gonna tell what Candy said about her. So you need a Sheree. Y'all need a Sheree on the show. You need that one person who's cool with everybody, that is the bone collector, and that's gonna drop that bone at the drop of a dime. That's Sheree. All right, y'all, that comes to the end of the show. We've been on here for an hour and 43 minutes. I need to get out of here. Which Monique? What Monique you talking about? Not Monique Samuels from Housewives of Potomac. You talking about comedian Monique? Are you talking about putting the comedian Monique on the Housewives show? They don't got a big enough a check for that. Oh, as a cameo, as a friend to the show. I could see her as a friend to the show, but they still don't have a big enough check for that, for her. Oh, and I forgot about Marlo. Oh, okay, so wait a minute. We got Marlo. But if they actually give Marlo a peach, we got to get rid of somebody. We got to get rid of somebody. I say get rid of Marlo, though. Marlo, I love you. You're just going to have to stay a friend to the show, because even though you had way more scenes this past season, you was basically in every fucking scene that you should have had a peach. And you brought us more into your life. You still was lackluster. You still didn't give us the Marlo Hampton that we grew to love. You know what I'm saying? It was almost like you needed Nene there. I said it. I'm sorry. It seemed like Marlo was missing that game piece that brought out the Marlo that we all grew to love. She held back a lot this past season. Marlo really held back. It was just like, and I know people say, well, she has grown or anything. I was like, no, this wasn't that. It's just she had nobody on that show to really challenge her. You know, she kind of went off here and there on Kenya and Drew and stuff, but it was still lackluster. Everybody was lackluster last season. I'm sorry. Everybody, not just Marlo, everybody. Kenya was the only one that was Kenya. Everybody else was kind of lackluster. Very lackluster. So I can't just say Marlo, but the Marlo that we knew wasn't the same Marlo last season. And it almost felt like she needed Nene there. Like, and that's okay. And that's okay. Sometimes we have that other person. Like, honestly, I wish Floozy was right here next to me. You know what I'm saying? It's okay that you need, there's a person that you probably need that brings out that side of you, that brings out that livelier side of you or something. Y'all feed off each other. Marlo didn't have anybody there to feed off of. And that person to feed off of is Nene. You know what I'm saying? Seeing Nene and Marlo together is a key. They better be careful before Marlo start writing her own checks again. Ooh, and on that note, we are out of here, y'all. Again, make sure y'all keep Marcus J. Donnie, aka Floozy, and his family in your prayers. Make sure you keep me and my family in your prayers. It's a lot going on, but we're still going to try to deliver DNT to you guys. For those that's been asking what's going on with our social media pages, I know we are so behind in a lot of stuff. I try. But y'all got to realize, I'm the one that's doing the social media pages, okay? Marcus A. Donnelly, he helps out when he can, but he got a lot of going on. He got a lot going on, y'all, okay? So we're revamping. We're not really focused too much on our social media pages right now because we're revamping, we're rebranding. We got a new logo coming out and everything. Everything is about to change. You know, it's the Naked Truth, now known as DNT, okay? So our social media pages, we will get back on top of that very, very, very soon. I will be doing a big move soon to a new location real soon. So it's just a lot going on. So just be patient with this, guys. I'm trying the best I can to keep our social media pages updated. But make sure you follow anyway. Make sure you follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, The Naked Truth. Make sure you follow me on my YouTube channel, The Real Foxy Bass. Make sure you subscribe and turn those notifications. And coming soon is the DNT TV, which will be our The Naked Truth YouTube channel. That is still coming. We just waiting on the new logo and all that stuff. Okay? That's about it, y'all. So in the face of your haters, I need y'all to say these words. Fuck them hoes over there. I need y'all to be you, be happy, be free, and love everybody. And until next week, y'all be safe and don't hurt anybody. Marcus said, who? All right, y'all. Bye, y'all. Check out the channel for my sister. My sister Lauren, okay? Just Lauren is premiering real soon. Check it out. That's my sister. I love you. Love you guys. Bye. I
can see. Your name is Jaylen.
I can see. And Jaylen is dead. It's clear
enough. Through that fight, I feel like I'm losing everybody.
Sometimes I feel like I'm being attacked.
The whole thing is just emotional.
I need support. Transgenders are losing their life every single day. And I could have lost my life over there because I chose to love myself.